I know of a language with no past, present, or future tense. Not even a word for before. And yet somehow this language can talk about time as well as you can. How? Well, here is the story of time in Maya, an extreme case of tenselessness. A Maya and a German are watching videos in a lab. Sounds like the start of a bad linguistics joke, but actually they're competing to see who's better at talking time in an experiment designed to investigate a difference between their languages. See, Mayatan, which linguists call Yucatec Maya, is fascinatingly unusual for something it lacks. No tenses, and not even basic time sequence words like before, until, or after. The researcher is eager to test whether this impacts the way they communicate about time. Here's the task. Enter two speakers of the same language, A and B. A watches two videos with two slightly different sequences of events. B only watches one of the videos. A describes both videos, then asks B a question about their single video. B answers. Based on that, A guesses which video B saw. Across 100+ runs of this task, speakers of both languages guess right at nearly the exact same rate. Despite its tenselessness, Maya seems no more timeless than German. Even outside of a modern lab, this quirk has history. Travel to Chiapas in the southeast of Mexico, and go about as far east as you can towards the border with Guatemala. Wade through the forests and let the sounds sink in. No fear, those are just the howler monkeys. As you approach the Usumacinta River, you come across the site of Yaxchilan. The structures here abounded with inscriptions. Above doorways, lintels with glyphs. Facing the buildings, stelae with glyphs. Even stairways leading up to the buildings were carved on the tread and on the riser. In front of structure 44 is stairway 3. On the tread of the first and the third steps, we see one verb used in two forms, chukach and chuki, is captured and was captured. These glyphs record history in classic Maya, an ancient relative of Yucatec. But despite my translation and just like in that study, they do it without tenses. How are Maya, past and present, going so tenseless? Well, here's a guess. When I remember first hearing about Mandarin, maybe tenseless languages rely on adverbials like yesterday or next year. Well, no, in fact, Maya speakers use words like these no more often and with no more emphasis than you do. The real answer isn't so simple. It works more like this. Hurricane Roxana struck the Yucatan Peninsula back in 1995. A week after it hit, a Maya speaker shared the story of when news came to Yaxle village ahead of the impending huracan. When we arrived, we saw everyone was saying they had heard on the radio the cyclone was coming. I count five verbs. All five were heard in a predictably and clearly timed way, and all five were tenseless. See, tense is a way for you to relate the time of the topic you're talking about to the time when you're speaking. But watch what happens when Maya drops tense and thinks about another property, aspect. This is about flow, not the when, but the how of time. Tan imbetik lenaho. This could be happening at any time. But with this non-perfective aspect here, it slices into an event that's happening, putting the topic inside that event. This ongoing topic feels unattached, like it's in search of some nearby reference point to chain itself to. A reference point like, well, look back at those classic stair-step glyphs that spell the word chuki. It's a perfective, and perfectives set events. They place the entire event time inside the topic time. Now behold the complex beauty that Maya grows from this grammatical seed in that hurricane news. Five verbs, five aspects. We arrive, we see, P people say they hear cyclone come. First, a new topic is set up. Arrived in town, realized what was happening. This is the reference point for the whole thing. Then comes a chain of non-perfectives. The talk was ongoing around that time. Well, hearing carries over from a previous time and this topic follows from it. The storm was also ongoing. Boom, exactly as expected. Maya tenselessness isn't only about aspects though. Ba'ashkena betech. The action here is aspect free. It partakes in the other part of Maya's solution to tenseless time, mood, which gives grammar a way to share our moods, our senses of obligation, desire, uncertainty, need. Factual statements are realis, real. Other moods are irrealis, unreal or not necessarily fact. The Maya future is not a fact, it's a mood. An irrealis mood. So when I ask, ba'ashkena betech, the unreal action is easy to interpret as future. What will you do? Just like in ba'ashta betach, the perfective event inside topic is readily translated as in the past. What did you do? Mood also gives Maya a way to say something like before without a word for it. Negative unreal plus event. You hadn't watched, I animated. It's not far from I animated before you watched. Are we playing semantics though? Is perfective just another word for past? Does irrealis actually mean future? Well, say you're asked about building a house 2 years ago, around now or next year, past, present, future. For each time, you can answer with most any aspect or mood. With nuances, our trusty perfective sets up a clean past event, does blow-by-blow reporting in the present, and has a conditional setup feel in the future. Whew. All that work for a glimpse of how one speaker of a Mayan language inscribed history into stair steps without tenses, and well over 1,000 years later, a speaker of a different Mayan language sat in a lab and communicated time accurately in an extremely tenseless language. Hachyum bo'otik te'esh. Gracias a mis patrocinadores at every level. This was a fun challenge. I'm animating a sequel to get into some of the more technical details too. Stick around and subscribe for language.